Right. Here we go.
Gamma going 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. Got me going.
Welcome to Philadelphia sign. It was like a location we had chosen anyway, and then we were like, oh, how perfect is this? Just because of its proximity.
Yeah.
Yeah, because Bruce might have done Philadelphia, but I'm from there.
Exactly.
Yeah, exactly.
You are Philadelphia. And I love that you had so many friends who like to skate or were skaters, you know? It was perfect.
Yeah, there's like an underground. A roller skating underground.
Yeah, everyone brought that razzle dazzle. Our girl Mare did that KV. You know, we were like, hey, Mayor, you gotta do something for Kurt. We need to build a Kurt altar. And then, like, 20 minutes later, she was like, check this out. And I was like, what the hell? Cool.
Yeah, I love Mayor because she made it chill.
Yeah.
She's got her charms. She's, like, on the sidelines making it chill.
Yeah.
Like,
that vibe.
Yeah, totally. We brought her on a few things just for that, you know what I mean? Like, just it's like, oh, we have our good vibe person over here holding space, you know? Welcome to the KV Hard Driving Movie Marathon. Should I give a tip to all the young filmmakers out there?
Sure.
Yeah.
My tip would be, psychedelia is not something that you can easily fake, I think. I think it's something you have to embody. So I took LSD on this day to imbue the whole thing with that, because it's not really about an effect or a camera angle or someone acting weird. It's like, it's an auric resonance. And I see people in the comments already saying like they feel like they're tripping out watching this. So I think that's why, you know, I was tripping out.
I didn't know. I mean, I'm not surprised.
Just a little.
Oh, this is my favorite. I love that girl with the neon.
Oh, yeah.
There's your
Jello
brother.
Man.
Jello Man.
There's Jello Man.
There's Rocky in the background. You see that?
Yeah.
He's the ringleader of the roller skating underground. I forget her name right now. And yeah. Also, some Madchester vibes, which I'm proud of accidentally capturing on both. I think we both accidentally captured that Madchester thing.
Yeah. Manchester vibes, I love that.
Madchester, like Happy Mondays.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
That kind of thing.
24-hour party people.
Yeah.
Shout out to Bob for these trippy effects that he was just stumbling on. This is an in-camera thing. We put a kaleidoscope filter.
James Stewart, I couldn't believe we got him.
Yeah.
He's a legend.
Oh, man.
This was my one main idea.
It was a good one.
Yeah, it was a good one.
I wanted to hold three guitars out of nowhere, different than the ones I was using, I was using all day. Based on a photo that's on the back of the record, actually.
James is such a pro, too. This was all happening so fast. He didn't question, like, what are you guys doing? What do you need me to do or anything? It was just like, he heard the music cue and he just played.
Yeah, he's a pro. He's there for the gig. It's no nonsense. Yeah. It's intimidating, but like he's not mean. He's just—he's amazing. He's actually shy, I think. Which, you know, so am I. Like,
yeah.
He's unreal. I can't wait to play with him again.
Yeah, I saw they're on some of your tour dates in Philly and New York.
Oh yeah, Sun Ra, yep. But I also just mean James in particular. I just can't wait to play with him.
Yeah. One of the things we were doing to achieve kind of a trippier effect, besides like kaleidoscope lenses and the filters and the colors, is we were playing the song at twice speed and having you lip sync to the song at twice speed. So when we slowed it down, it just like has this dreamy feel to it.
Sure, I love that trick, and yeah, I feel like from now on, you never know which one you need. You usually need both. It's like you almost got to do it fast. Do your video fast and then do it regular speed, because you're gonna want the options. But that, yeah, I'll slow down here. Unbelievable. This scene makes me cry.
Oh yeah, that's one of my favorite shots.
And with Sam, his brother's shot.
Oh yeah,
that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. No, that's Rennie's kids.
Oh, that's Rennie's kids?
Oh, no way.
Oh, my God, that's so funny. Yeah. I didn't know that. And I love that Suzanne wore, like, a disco ball outfit.
Oh, that was
She
incredible.
Was definitely the belle of the ball.
Yeah,
right here.
Right here.
Yeah, Hayne, the one with the big smile, that's usually with Suzanne, but she has, like, this iconic smile at one point. She brought it. She visited from New York. She's Suzanne, one of our oldest friends from New York, Hayne, and she's also a great artist, Hayne Co. She's a really hot artist in New York right now.
Oh, cool.
She showed up with that outfit and dressed up the girls all sequiny, and yeah, here we go. Here's my favorite scene. Here's my favorite shot when it fades out.
It's coming. Yeah, you just did a little wink. There we are. Yeah.
What an amazing video. You guys made an amazing video.
You made an amazing song.
This is a case where the video makes the song better, I feel like. Or like they both make each other better, I guess. But it's weird. It's beautiful. Honestly, I never had so much fun making a video, and it turned out incredible. I can't wait till we're definitely gonna be working together again on some other things. We have things planned.
But I was thinking, like, if we're gonna do something for you, it really has to honor you. I cannot be a part of shoehorning you into some experience that it just doesn't vibe with the song. So, and like honestly, this was we met you in July, and we started working together. The music video has felt like the most laid back thing we've done, and it was definitely the most high pressure thing by far that we've
for
done.
You.
But this is the first song that you played for us off this new album. It wasn't
I know
state, but that was the first thing you played for us, and we loved it.
That's the cosmic thing, right?
Yeah.
To name drop the B-52s, or to name whatever. But that is a cosmic thing. And that stuff's real. Like, yeah, you came in while I was like laying down some synths to that song, which like the band, I knew that song had potential. It was in a Zoom recorder when I was feeling really down one day. I wrote it. It sounds like a, you know, just a hypnotic Neil Young outtake from Psychedelic Pill or something. And then I was like feeling, I was trying to get my studio working, and the first day was cool with the band. Then I woke up with a migraine, and I was like, well, we can't try any of these new songs. Why don't you guys just play over top of this demo? And that was like earlier in the day, and you guys came like mid-afternoon. And by the time you got there, I was just like, there's a moment where I hit like this ring modulator in the song, and it's just like, bah, 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 bah. It got me going, woo, bah, bah. And I was literally like with the band before you were there. I was just like laughing. I was like, this sounds terrible. Listen, dun, 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 dun. But it sort of sounds like in Gloria when he's like, when she comes to my house. And like, and then like the drums just go crazy. They're like, bow, bow, bow. Make me feel all right. Like, but it was really literally me laughing like to the band. So that's the beauty. Like at first I was like, I don't know what's happening here. And we add these guitars really fast. I still didn't think I cared. And then you showed up. I was playing these synths over top of it. And yeah, and you guys walked in and I was nervous. I'm always nervous before I know people, you know, and like hear it. But you know, you knew Drew who you know, that was our connection. Drew, who was the DP of this video, and Drew, who did my Loading Zones video. Now we're all just this happy family.
Yeah.
But the video, I don't want to say it sealed the deal, because we've already done so much cool stuff, but it also, like, it was like the full, now we're in every dimensional, you know?
Yeah.
And now it's every dimensional.
Yeah, totally.
You made making this video so easy, because I had like put together a very tight schedule and you just like nailed every take. And like, as documentarians, we like only usually do one take for things. So for you, just even if you were feeling sick, just showing up and being in your universe where you were just walking down the street with the guitar and just showing up fully, it really made our job super easy.
Yeah, that was the make or break part of it. You know, it was like, cool, we scheduled the day, somehow we're going to pull this off. But like, if Kurt's not that good at doing that, and I don't know, I haven't worked with you in that capacity, I'm like, if it's going to take multiple takes, there's no way we're going to pull this off today. Like, we just had too much to do. And it was literally like one take every time. And I'm not the type of director that thinks things get better the more you shoot them. I think there's that moment to capture, and if you don't capture it, it's just going to get worse and just feel more contrived. But you came and killed it, and it was awesome. You know, we were trying to do like a Streets of Philadelphia, like that Bruce Springsteen video. We were trying to do something like that, and you know, the idea for me was like, how do we show, like, you know, Kurt's like waking reality, what that kind of feels like on the streets of Philadelphia, literally. And then the idea was like, you to have like these DMT activations that pull you into through this portal into through the mind's eye, straight through to the mind's eye. And that was what the skating part is, you know. And you know, like the idea came from you and James, the sax player, talking in the studio one day, and James was saying he was a skater, and then you were like, oh, my wife wants to do a skating video. And I was like, cool, well, if the opportunity comes up, that's what I'm gonna pitch. And
you fed us the idea to do this.
Yeah,
that was amazing. But yeah, you said this really, actually, is it you who, well, you've written a couple pitches, or you collectively all have, but there's always like this one line, and on this one you're like, we're all just trying to get back to the rave at this point. We're all just trying to get to the rave. I was like, yeah, because the roller skating was key, but also you wanted to take it to a disco rave, more or less. And like, and that's the beauty, that's like such a, yeah, because James Stewart, the sax player, like the song's coasting along awesomely, and the video is, but then like, just when it could like get old, probably not, but a chance it could, like out of nowhere pops James, and he's just in his whole Sun Ra garb playing the sax, and that's incredible. Everything's melting. But then, and the same thing happens again, like once you get to the rave, it takes this uplifting turn, the dance party with everybody like so happy, and like so many different types of people. It's like just the most uplifting thing, but it's also psychedelic as hell. And I feel like nobody's touched that anytime lately or something, you know. They're probably gonna try now, but
yeah, totally. Totally. Yeah, I mean, I was intimidated at first, because this is a long, like, even when I've done music videos in the past and the song's 4 minutes, I'm always like, can we do just a 2 minute music video? And they're always like, no. And for this, I was like, maybe we could do a radio cut down, because it's intimidating length. And once we got in the edit, I was like, oh, we're not going to need to do that at all. It's so compelling. And our editor, Bob Weiss, who also did all the visual effects and created those visual effects, like, unreal.
Oh, the editor did the visuals.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
So you didn't have an outside animator like you?
No, just one guy.
Okay, because you mentioned animators at one point, but maybe that's who you meant. Yeah, he's amazing.
We have people on standby for the other stuff that we're working on together, but like, this was such a quick turnaround, and I asked Bob to do it, and he has a lot of experience with music videos, so he actually called us like 2 days into it, like, this is, I've never had I've never made a music video so like that's so slow. He's like, normally the stuff I'm making, the BPM is through the roof. So he was just like, wow, it's so luxurious to just let a shot play out a little bit and it doesn't feel slow. So it was he killed it on the edit, and he started putting these effects together, and the idea is that it would just slowly get more and more trippy to the point where by the end we're just like in maximal trippy zone, you know, everything fully
way.
I think that was accomplished.
The one thing I wasn't afraid, but I wanted to make sure it didn't get scary, you know, like, cause it could also get scary. Like a trip can get scary, but like, I think the dance party ensured there was nowhere else to go, but up, you know?
Absolutely. And that was a part I was like, all right, everyone, we're going to do a dance sequence. If you want to be in it, just meet in the middle. And we just started playing the hits. And it was that actual dance party, like, to the point where it's like, I was like, cool, we got the things over. They're like, keep it going. And like, your girls kept dancing and everything. And I was like, wow, okay, cool, I can shoot it. I think that dance footage looks better than shit you see in movies, better than shit you see in TV shows, because it's real, you know?
Yeah, I think so too. And the one secret was we had people dance to, like, actual dance music. They didn't, if we had them dancing to the song, they probably, I don't know how you would dance to the song. But you could, but it wouldn't be like that. But we had them dancing to like Pump Up the Jam and things like that. And it was the end of the shoot. And everybody was stoked because they were roller skating all day. Unreal.
Really. And it really felt like we had a lot of angels with us. Oh my God.
Everything. The weather, even. The weather cooperated. So the angels were with us in that way. The place that we shot the roller skating, what was that place called?
Rolling Thunder Skating Center.
Rolling Thunder. Shout out to Bob Dylan. You know?
Yeah.
That place,
yeah, which is, they probably didn't, I'm pretty sure they have no idea about that, you know.
my favorite place about that was like all the Philadelphia iconography on the walls, like Rocky
punching the Liberty bell. It's the best.
Oh wow, I missed that actually.
Yeah, the murals that were spray painted onto the side were incredible.
Well, I love that when you get stressed, you still seem very calm, cool, and collected.
Yeah.
You know, wow. So it's, having worked with you for this long, it's like, we tell people, we're like, Kurt is his music.
You know what I mean? Yeah, you really are like that.
Yeah, you wow. Inhabit it fully.
Thank
or
you.
Or maybe you go scream in a pillow or something between takes or something, you know.
I just get physically, my brain. It's painful. After a while, I just fall asleep. But you know, and then things go, you know, this is the payoff. And then I get cocky, and then I get really cocky for a minute, and then I say all these cocky things, and then I'm like, oh, I should have said that. And then I'm like, ah, everybody's the same. not exactly that, but like, I'm like, oh, just be humble.
I love it
because it's like we filmed with you so much that I feel like we have all versions of you, but when and it's few and far between that version of you pops up, but when it does, it like reminds me of something in myself. I'm like,
that's raw.
This record's gonna be your best, and I'm like, it is. Fuck yeah. And like, well, I'm getting pumped up with you.
Well, I come to collect. I'm taking names, and I'm pissed.
Yeah, man.
So I've come to collect. Like, it's just enough's enough.
You're the voice of a generation.
Yeah.
Well, I will say, having gotten a sneak peek at the album, you have every reason to be very cocky, and it's about to be your best record yet by far, and we are huge fans.
Yeah, that's how we got in on all this. That's why Drew even introduced us, because like, that's how we know Drew. Like, he was trying to get on our radar for a while, and like a lot of cinematographers send their work our way, and I'm just like, I don't know, I already got my people. You know, it'd be like guitar players sending you stuff. It's like, what? Okay. But then he sent us a video that he did for you, and I was like, oh shit, you know Kurt, like, cool, let's be friends. And that's where it started. And like, we were obsessed fans of yours, you know, probably since Childish Prodigy. And we use your stuff for, I've told you, like tripping on acid, ketamine, mushrooms. We, you know, we've really tested this music in every realm and every dimension. And, you know, it's kind of why when we're making this video, I don't want it to be startling. I don't want it to be scary, because it's like, I know how people could be using this. It's also why when we first met you, we're like, hey, long songs really work for us in terms of being your fans. The longer, the better. Yeah.
I knew what you meant. So you've worked with Drew a lot, though. Yeah, or no, not really.
Yeah, we went to the Caribbean with him, and we did a documentary this summer with him. And yeah, we've actually just become really good friends. He introduced us to Ween, which it became one of our new favorite bands. And then you introduced us to Dean Ween. Thank you for that.
Drew shot some commercials for us, and we became buddies. And then this summer we were out in Indiana making this film that's gonna come out called American Sunset. Stay tuned for that. And we're gonna do lots of other stuff with Drew. But he had a baby in the middle of all this, so.
Yeah, he's a cinematographic genius.
Oh my God.
I hope that word's not real.
The nicest, most chill guy. Like, really, yeah. A pleasure to work with in that way. We've worked with a lot of different people, and rarely does someone bring that kind of vibe to the set where it's just like, it's chilled out. You can't really shake him. He's funny, you know, like we just keep everything real. I associate it with Philly now. Like, it seems like everyone I know from Philly is cool. Like, it can't be, you know, too easily worked up. I don't know. Maybe it's just y'all out in Mount Airy.
Well, no, I sort of had that epiphany or re-epiphany because I was, you know, I had to travel a lot for what I do. And I feel like along the way, all my people I play with or connections, I sort of realize they're all over the world and not necessarily in Philly. All of a sudden, in the old days, obviously it was all Philly. And then I was like, wait a minute, I need to get this back to Philly, you know? So yeah, Drew, we connected, and even my buddy Adam, who helped me build the studio, but now it's convenient because people are fleeing New York or whatever.
Yeah.
Cause like certain engineers I've worked with, now they're in Philly, like Ted Young. So now I'm vindicated just because I've chilled out as I've gotten older anyway, but I'm also just like, my music wouldn't sound like this if I had ever thought I had to leave, you know?
That's a really interesting thing, because we have a lot of musician friends that move to LA, and man, it's inevitably when I fall off with their music, it's so weird where you're doing it could affect how it comes out so much, you know?
Yeah, well, of course that's not always the case, but I think, yeah, I don't know. Well, these times are even more different because people don't, I feel like now a place isn't a place anymore because everybody's just looking through a screen wherever they are. Even now, but whatever, man, I got a family. I'm just glad I didn't leave. There was a moment where I thought I had to go somewhere else you know, and then the pandemic hit, and I was working towards the same. I was exhausted anyway, and I was working towards having a place where I could work, you know, that in at home, and it was weird because then I could feel it coming on. I could feel it coming in the air tonight, you know. I could feel that all this shutdown was going to happen, and I was like, I took advantage of it, you know. Even, you know, and then there was a lot of scary parts too, but ultimately here we are.
Yeah, I mean, you're doing a whole new thing with this album. You're recording from your basement, so this is like a new territory that seems like required you to take more space with this album, which is, I think, paid off really beautifully, right?
And also Rob Schnapp, who I worked with on previous albums, he's always done at least a few tracks, but But then, yeah, then I also knew because of all this, I knew, I was like, well, Rob Schnapp, who I actually call on the phone, you know, I'm friends in one way or another with everybody I've worked with, but, you know, Rob Schnapp, we talk all the time, and he's like a bro, a brother, but also like a dad, you know, just to make him feel old. He's all those things. But so, yeah, it was cool to be like, all right, I'm going to work from home as much as I can, but then I know I can always go to Rob Schnapp's professional studio in LA, you know, ASAP. We got some good stuff in the can before the pandemic hit anyway. So I knew it wasn't totally stressful. You know, it wasn't stressful because of that. And then I was like, as soon as I can get back, I'm going to get back. And when he wasn't here, he was just telling me what gear to buy and things like that. And we had, you know, our Philly peeps, like I was saying. So, yeah.
Well, this is a blast. Thanks so much for talking with us, Kurt, and doing this video and trusting us with this. And it was just seriously the pleasure of our life. So thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you. It's a beautiful friendship. We're going to keep doing stuff. I just knew right away. I was like, well, that's, you know, I'm comfortable and these people get it. And we'll just keep doing stuff because there's no contest, you know.
Oh, yeah, totally.
Oh, we love it. We're here for you always, so.
And cool. Stay tuned for a documentary project we have in the works.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yep.
Cool. Well,
see you. All right. All right, see ya. Thanks.
Bye, Kurt.
Bye.